Welcome back to Let's Play Super Mario Galaxy. This is Brentonitis, and we're back. We're back with this game. It's been a while because, of course, it has. It's always a while between recording sessions because I normally just don't feel up to it. It's not that I don't want to. It's that I just physically can't sometimes. But anyways, last time we got the game all started up. And we got a couple stars in Good Egg Galaxy, and now we have enough to unlock this new one, which is Honey Hive Galaxy. Pretty awesome. This one, I'd say this one's even more of a classic than Good Egg Galaxy. Even though you start with that one, this one is like, you know, the quintessential. All right, B Mario Takes Flight. It's the quintessential Mario Galaxy level. It's so good. I believe they actually reuse this map, but just like flip it later in the game, which is funny. All right, B Mario Takes Flight. Yeah, we're gonna get some cool new the power-ups here that have not been in previous Mario games. All right, you can look around with the R stick. Huh? Just gonna be careful. Oh, and there we go. It wants you to look around so you can get that. You know, the advantage of this game is you can use the actual stick to look around. That's pretty good. I like that improvement. I just wish it was smooth like in Sunshine. Welcome to the Honey Hive Kingdom. Our queen rules this land. Ah, interesting. The downside of these controls is the gyros. I don't enjoy the gyros, to be honest. Alright. That's enough of that. Alright, let's go ahead and grab this the question mark coin. That guy's running away. Alright, let's see what we got. We got a B-shroom! Transformed to B Mario. Hold B to buzz around. So B Mario is pretty cool. He can fly, but only very limitedly. Also, if you touch water, he will transform back. So careful not to trust water. All right. Camera angle is not great here. All right. So these guys will attack you as B Mario, but as regular Mario, they will not. Also, yet another one-up. Just so many. Oh, what? That has never happened to me before. Alright, I have played this game many times. That has never happened to me. Where's the first-person button? No, that is not it. Oh, is there... I could have sworn there was, like, a button... Oh, there it is. Oh, you just keep pushing up on the right stick. I wanna... No, I can't reach him. Wow. I wanted to get him back, but, you know, oh well. Anyways, back to B Mario. Yeah, you pretty much don't have to worry about, losing your power up, because it's pretty abundant in levels that require it. Also, as you can see, there are certain platforms you can only go on as B Mario. As regular Mario, you're too heavy and the flower will perish. Honey is heavy. Yeah? I believe Mario's spin attack gets kind of a nerf when you're in B form, but that's okay. We're not really meant for fighting, we're meant for flying. Yeah, like, see, there's plenty of B power-ups, you don't even have to worry. Also, if you get hit even once, it's gonna be a bad time. So don't do it, don't get hit. And... a little bit of a boost. There we go. Yeah, the backflip will give you... I think it gives you, at least, a little bit of extra. Alright, And as Bee Mario, we can also climb on the sticky bits. Alright, but before that, we got this going on. Alright, careful of the depth perception here. I have fallen here more than once, actually. Because it's like curved and just, yeah. Yeah, and you can recover stamina here, which is great. Yeah, we got a little extra here. Don't think it's timed or anything, so. Also, gravity is just a little odd on this thing. Alright. You know, one day I'll go through the trouble of actually disconnecting the Joy-Cons and using those. That would be easier for the pointer. And who might you be? A physician, we presume? No matter. We are in the most vexing predicament and require assistance. Most furious itchiness plagues our entire being. It must be stopped. Please find the source at once. And as you can see, there's these little like star chips. And as Bee Mario, we can climb on the queen, because that's not weird, right? Okay. So we just gotta collect these. One left. There we go. My thanks, you have shown much bravery, newbie. Trust that we may rely on you in the future. Alright. I am holding up, and Mario is going for a nosedive there. Okay. And here we go, we're at the end of this mission. Alright. How are we ever gonna get back? Yeah, I wonder. I mean, I'm gonna take the star and use that to get back, but you know. Ah, Bee! What, Mario? Hey, it's you. We escaped from Peach's castle too. But then we thought Bowser would get us. Then we got lost with Luigi. Oh, I just remembered. We found a power star. I'm sure you need this, so here, take it. And we got a power star. You guys are all stuck up here, but didn't you know? You could use this to just leave. Maybe you have to have visited the observatory first before the star would let you move here? I don't know. I don't know Mario Universe logic. I score 30. Alright, nice. Mario, your name is Mario, isn't it? That's what I heard from your friends who just arrived. Mario, it has such a nice ring. Your friends are waiting for you at the garage. Think they want to tell you something, you best hurry over there. Okay. Shave your game. Oh, I should have probably said no in case something happens to the recording. Oh, well. Lesson learned. Oh, hey, a letter. Yeah, I want a letter. Mr. Mario, check it out, I'm Meltoad, and I have a letter for you. Dear Mario, I'm in a faraway place, but I'm coming, but I'm all right because you're coming to rescue me. I just immediately jumped to the next word, like the physically closest word. P.S. I hope this gift will come in handy. Okay. Included 5 1-up mushrooms. Yeah. Even when she's kidnapped, the princess is so thoughtful. Come to see me next time there's mail delivery. Okay. What's the sign say? Garage, your one-stop shop for intergalactic starship repairs. Alright, and here we got Captain Toad. Somehow we made it too. We'll help you get the power stars and save Princess Peach. Count on us, Mario. We're all in this together. Alright. Captain Toad ended up getting his own game. Isn't that crazy? Lumas are gonna build us a ship when it's done. Let's look for Princess Peach and Power Stars. And we got the nerd one. Because he's got glasses. What if he's not a nerd? What if he's a jock, but he just has glasses? He just has bad eyesight. You ever think of that, huh? So I guess this place is some kind of mobile space station controlled by that Rosalina lady. But who exactly is she, anyway? She's not a witch, is she? Is she? No, that's ridiculous, right?
Oh no.
Alright, so let's head back to this dome over here. And, yeah. Long jumping. Not a great idea. Alright, what else we got going on here? Oh, a bunch of question marks. That we cannot interact with yet. Tis fine. We have a Honey Hive Galaxy. Let's go back there because there's more stars. Two more, in fact. Alright, let's see. We have Trouble on the Tower. I'm not gonna lie. I don't remember Oh, no, I remember exactly what this one is. I was like, what could this possibly be? And then I remembered. This is kind of reminiscent of, Womp's Fortress in Mario 64. Oh my goodness, we have so many lives already. And I will probably end up closing this game before the next time I record. So yeah, we're gonna lose them probably. Yeah, so this is just to teach you the mechanic of ground pound on those, get extra height. Pretty intuitive tutorial, huh? Alright, we got Wiggler. Is it gonna flip over? Yeah. Again, just like more like really good tutorials. Egoraptor would be happy with that. He loves that kind of thing. I mean, I love that kind of thing too. It's very cool. Alright. It's me, the famous Gilboard. If you want to climb this wall, you better listen up. When you stick to the wall after a jump, press B to do a wall jump. Yeah, I know about wall jumps. There's a hole here. Can I go in here? That's weird. What? Why did I think there was like a one-up hidden? Oh, no, no, no. No, it's not. It's not a real opening. Okay. There we go. I have to turn the controller so awkwardly sometimes. Alright, I'm gonna stop complaining. Ooh, wait. What if I... Okay, well that's not helpful. Ba-da-ba! Ah! Oh, I got a ton of them right there. Yeah, these star bits are gonna be real helpful later. Because right now it's like, oh, are you collecting them? Because we're gonna need them. Eventually. Hopefully I'll have enough when the time comes. Oh boy, go ahead and grab it. Rainbow Mario, you're invincible. Excellent. Alright. All the way down. I thought maybe I would get something from that, but I didn't. Alright. Maybe I should have just gone straight down the hole. But... Oh, they didn't anticipate that now, did they? I mean, it wouldn't have been that hard to get up here, but like... I know a thing or two. Actually, isn't this supposed to move? Oh, I have to do this first, I'm sure. Okay, well, you know, I thought it was clever. I was like, oh, look, a shortcut. Speedrunning tactics. But actually, you had to go over there anyway, so. Oh well. Do 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 do. Alright, we got a mini boss. Smushed the little one. Oh, he's the big mad. There we go. Only two hits. That's pretty mini. It's pretty mini for a mini boss. I'll grab one of those. Even though the star restores my health, I might as well. Huzzah. Alright, so that's two stars this episode, and counting. Alright, Trouble in the Tower. High score updated. Alright. Discovered a new galaxy! Not yet. Alright, new galaxy, now that we have more star power. It is Loop-de-Loop Galaxy. Oh, ooh, I wonder how this is gonna control with this one. So, with the Wii Remote, this actually controls pretty alright. With this controller, we're gonna find out. Alright, Surfing 101. I think there might be two stars here, but I'm not 100% sure. That's very Sunshine reminiscent, that gate there. Look at that friendly, what are they called? Manta rays? Stingrays? Are manta rays and stingrays different things? I am not a marine biologist, don't ask me. Around here we surf on rays. I'm serious, we call it ray surfing. That's what we do. Alright, and Starbit. Okay. We got the big boy penguin. What's up? Are you a surfer too? Sure. First time ray surfing, right? Well, let me show you the ropes. Explanation. Match the guide on the bottom. Okay. Yep, that's the basic position. Turn left. That's how you turn left. Okay. And turn right. Did that. Oh, I have to hold it. Yeah, there we go. That's how you turn right. All you need to do is hold down B to speed up. That's all you need to know. Now give it a go. Alright, and it doesn't seem like it's like timed or anything. Ah, you know what, this control's fine. I prefer the Wii Remote, but this is good actually. Let's get going to the real course. Oh boy. This music always like induces panic, you know? It's something about it. I'm sure somebody who's well versed in music theory will be like, well, actually, it's because this chord transitions to this chord. You know what I mean? Do you know what I mean? We all know things. Some of us more so than others. Actually, you know, this is, seems easier? Is this easier? Or am I just a more experienced gamer after, you know, whenever this last came out? I'm just trying not to fall off the edge, because that might be, like, just an automatic loss. Oh, is that it? Wow, 102. That's pretty good. Congratulations, you deserve a gold medal. Oh, nice. I wonder if you have to get it under a minute for like another star. I do not recall, actually. And I don't think I ever got the guidebook to this game, but I still 100%ed it, so. I don't think it really gives you too many stars that are like super cryptic. Alright. That's our third star, so we're already on par with the last episode. And it's been half the time. Oh, well, it says it's complete, so. That. That sure handles it. Alright, we can't quite go over there yet. And I do not recall how to get this third star. So this will be interesting. I might end up, like, cutting ahead a bit. Depends. King Caliente's battle fleet. Well, actually, it might just tell us where to go and how to do things. Let's see. Yeah, I don't think we have to worry about getting lost here. It seems like... Let's see. Seems like we can just go right there. Oh, look at all this stuff. New stuff. I like new stuff. Oh, let's free this toad. Ooh, you saved me. Thanks, Mario. In return, I'll let you an honest secret about this place. Apparently, those spiky things just hate coconuts. Shake or press blah to smack them with coconuts. Okay. Very cool. I already knew such things, but... There we go. And we're off. Yeah, do I need coconuts for this? I was like, I already know what to do, and then suddenly I don't. Oh, here's some coconuts. Whoop, boom. Easy peasy. What is a peasy, though? People say easy peasy, but do they know what a peasy is? It's got to be a word in some language. I don't know. Sounds Italian, actually. Ooh, give me the good stuff. Alright, let's see. I am holding one direction. Why are you going in circles, Mario? Let's... Oh, I want to beat this one too. We did it. Hey, sometimes you just gotta have a little fun. I know it's not required to do that, but... Fun is the something of joy. You know what they say. All toast is toast toast. That kind of thing. I think in my old age, I've just, you know, lost it. Alright. Ow. My guy, that was so not necessary. I was just leaving anyways. I probably should have grabbed a coin. Alright. Alright, we got a toad we can rescue. There's a coin. Hi, toad. Nice work, you gotta keep going, okay. There's a boss fight in this level, right? Pretty sure it's after this. Oh man. Right between the blades. Oh, hey there, Luma. Gotta give me something? Big danger up ahead. Things get really bad. Shoot the things. Okay. Yeah, we knew this. How we could get some coins for the restoring of health. Oh boy. Oh, excuse me? It just went straight from cutscene to you are now getting hurt. And there we go. Ah, some back and forth. Some of that, some of them Ganondorf techniques, huh? Oh boy. I was actually looking for one of these. Boom. Oh, that's it.
Wow.
There's I think there's a harder version of that boss later in the game. I could be wrong. Maybe I'm thinking of Mario Galaxy 2. Which is a great game that did not come out on the Switch. So if I ever let's play that, I am probably going to use an emulator. With a real legal copy, by the way, I must say. I have the physical disc, I'll just, you know, copy it onto my computer. Which, sure, Nintendo doesn't like it when you do that, for some reason, even though I paid them. But it's 100% legal, so might as well. Alright, you've discovered a new galaxy. Alright. And there's a hungry Luma outside! We can feed him! Let us feed the Luma. Woohoo! Alright, how many star bits do you need? Got any tasty star bits? Feed me a bunch, I'll burst with snacky happiness. Need 400. Yep, I have just enough. That's it, I'm stuffed. Here we go. Transform! He's so happy to explode. Good for him. Sweet, sweet galaxy has appeared. So, typically these are... I guess you could call these, like, challenge... These are, like, more challenging galaxies, typically. But since we're still kind of, you know, early in the game, it should be not that hard, actually. Alright, Rocky Road. Dun, dun, dun. This one's like slightly tricky, but it's not like crazy. If you've beaten Mario Sunshine 100%, this kind of thing is just like, oh, you know, no big deal. Or it should be. Now watch me fail it. Oh, this is just like some real nostalgic music. This is from Mario 3? Mario Bros. 3? Oh, whoa, oh. I was so busy fighting One Direction that I was like, oh, it switched. And I didn't realize I can't go any farther. Well, maybe you can't, but I'm Super Mario. You're just normal Toad. All right, careful on them long jumps. Risky jumps. Let's go. Alright, we're almost there. My palms are, like, actually sweaty. But it's also very hot in here. It's still summer. Alright. Oh no, I revealed the hemisphere in which I live. Whatever shall I do? It's not like 80% of the world's population lives in the same hemisphere. Alright, we got a power star. And we'll collect some of these to make up for what we lost. Alright, let's grab some of those. There's some over there. Alright, that helps. And we got it. Wow, I feel like I died in the last episode and I just forgot, but... no deaths so far in this episode. That's good. Da-da-da! 8. Galaxy complete. Very cool. Discovered a new galaxy. Ah, we got 2. Alright. Nice. So let's check out this new stuff. We have discovered an enemy base in the region. We can only hope they're not misusing the power of that poor Grand Star. Alright. So let's see, we got this one, and then we got this one way over here. Now, if I recall, we cannot actually get every star here just yet. We'll actually have to come back to this domain area, solar system, whatever you want to call it. We'll have to come back here eventually. But for now, let's take a look at Flip Switch Galaxy. I know we're jumping around slightly, but you know, it's my Let's Play. We're just having a good old time. Painting the planet yellow. I kind of like these flip switch levels. See, I say that and now I'm gonna get my first death. Just you watch. That's just how it always be. The universe won't let me enjoy things. Alright. Oh, careful, this guy. Yeah, you can stun him like that. Is helpful. Okay. Oh boy. Alright, can you come over here? How do I... I should have gone over here first, shouldn't I have? Thankfully, it shows you, like, where it's gonna go. Alright, cool, cool. Yeah, I totally should have came here first, but... Alright. And this one's... sorry, the commentary just suddenly stopped. Oh, that was it? Oh, I thought it was gonna take me to another one of these. Oh, guess not. But I was like actually concentrating there for a minute. I was just like, oh no. Because you can't really change the camera angle most of the time. So you're kind of just like stuck with what you got. Which is actually interestingly part of the challenge. All right, Flip Switch Galaxy. Got a star, galaxy complete. And we're gonna go back up here. And looks like we got one more before we head to that most distant one. Alright. What do we got? Big Bad Bugaboom. That could be a tongue twister, right? Big Bad Bugaboom. Big Bad Bugaboom. Lots of bees. In two ways. The title and also this world. Yes. Oh. Oh well. Alright. I don't recall exactly what to do. I think we'll take the Bubble Express. Alright. That'll work. Ooh, we got a mushroom. Now this mushroom is really cool because it will increase our maximum life. If it drops below 4, it will return to normal. So careful not to do that. I'd like to see where I'm going. Oh goodness, it looks like I'm lost. Oh, we got this, though. This will help us. Alright, let's go back up here. Now that we got this, we can explore a lot more freely. There we go. All right. Huh. Why do I feel as though this is not where I'm supposed to be going? Alright, are we supposed to go see the Queen, perhaps? Oh, well, the Queen's right here. Let's go talk to her. Neighbors are causing trouble again. We would be most grateful for your assistance. Alright. I figured it out pretty quickly. My memories of this game are pretty ancient, so... Alright. Boom. Gives us enough of a boost to fly over. Flying, or like hovering with style. Alright, boss time. Of course we know what to do. Exactly that. Let's go! We kicked his butt! Ha ha ha, I got him again. Now if you want to be real sure you get the timing right, you can go up on these things. Then he flips around. Oh, I think he's gotta flip around again. Why are you hugging the tree, Mario? Yeah. Oh, I almost got him anyway. Oh, that was close. The first two hits are obviously the easiest. Oh, don't touch the water. Ah, that was close. Come on, man. He's just trolling me. He's just trolling me, man. Oh, got him. That last hit was a little more tricky than I thought it would be. But that's all right. We got him good. We cleaned his clock. I don't know why beating someone up is called cleaning their clock, but you know. Cleaning someone's clock like a bad thing, you know? Many mysteries of idioms. Alright, Honey Hive Galaxy. Pretty much complete. Not quite. Because later in the game, we will have access to more things to do in these places, which is pretty cool. But for now, the only thing left to do to see what Bowser's up to. Bowser Jr.'s robot reactor. I don't recall if this is a level and then a boss, or it's just, you know, just a boss by itself. Alright, let's see. Mega Legs Moon. Let's go! This is our first, like, big boy boss fight, you know? I remember seeing, like, trailers, and this guy was in the trailers for this game, like, way back in the day, and it was, like, so hype. It's like, yo, look at that thing! You know? Alright, looks like we have to get a bullet bill to follow us. Follow me, William. That's his name, right? No one's ever made that joke before, right? Except everyone has. Alright, there's Bowser Jr. with his, I don't know, handkerchief or whatever it's called. That he uses as a bib, but also a mask. Wahahaha, you made it. But I won't even need my dad's help to take care of you. Go get him, Megaleg. Stomp him with the power of your grand star. Alright. And here's the big boy. Now, foolishly, Bowser Jr. Put gravity plating on Megaleg here. Allowing us to, you know, climb up his leg. Seems like a bit of a design flaw. Alright. Let us go up here. There we go. Just have to move out of the way at the last second so the bullet bill will hit that. Usually a backflip does well. Anyone want to come this way? I probably have to bait them like this. Sometimes they also hit each other. Oh my goodness, it went over it. That's an actual speedrunning strat, I'm pretty sure. Getting it to go over. And just like that, the biggest, baddest boss we've faced so far was actually one of the easiest. So I guess it's not that big or bad. Well, actually, it was very big. It was colossal. It was one of those Shadow of the Colossus type moments. I've never played that game. But I'm pretty sure it was still one of those moments. Alright, now that we got a Grand Star, this will expand the scope of our adventure. Activates one of the things there. There's, what was there, five? That's a lot of things. Alright. 11 stars so far. That's so many. So many. Alright, discovered a new galaxy. Two of them, actually. Here's Rosalina saying things again. That ball of flame represents the power of the observatory. We call it the beacon. When you recover a grand star, a little star power will be restored and the beacon will grow. The Comet Observatory can use that power to fly through the universe. Once all the power is restored, we'll even be able to fly to the center of the universe. Here's Black Luma saying something. Oh, the power is on in a new dome. Alright, newly opened dome is called the Fountain. It's really quite relaxing. By the way, have you looked at the map? It contains information. Yes, we see it sometimes. Alright, don't hesitate to speak with me. Alright. Not yet. Alright, so yeah, those two will finish later when we get the chance. And we have some stuff going on in the fountain. So I say we go and maybe get one more star for this episode. I like recording longer, more chunkier episodes nowadays. You know, really, really pack in that content. Is there... For some reason, I thought there was a 1-up back here. I guess I'm wrong. You know what? Actually, I think, like, post-game, there is actually something back there. Alright, so we got this one. A Space Junk Galaxy. And then we've got Rolling Green Galaxy. Ooh. Hmm. Space Junk Galaxy, I'm gonna want to have the Joy-Cons for that one, trust me. So, let's do this one first. Alright, we got, Rolling in the Clouds. Rolling around at the speed of sound. This joke is obligatory, oh yeah! Alright, so this one uses motion controls. You know what? This might actually be better than the Wii version. Let's take a little look. Hey, if you're thinking about just rolling the ball away, better listen to old Billboard here. Another Bill. First, jump on and get it on top of the ball. Alright, I'm holding it steady. Oh, you want me to hold it like this? Oh no. Oh, that's awkward. The basic position? No. No. Oh no, this is gonna be... How am I supposed to... So, you can't see it, but I'm holding my controller in a way that is, like, not... anatomically comfortable? Okay, wait. If I move my arms like okay. I'm holding it in a way that, like, the face buttons are, like, facing me instead of facing, like, upward. Okay, well, you know, I guess this works. See, I thought I would be able to control this kind of like, kind of like the surfing one, right? So for the surfing one, I could hold the controller like flat, like as if it was like on a table. But this one is different. So, no, I am not getting that one up. Forget them one-ups. Let's see if we can have a deathless episode. That'll be... Oh, don't jinx yourself, you fool. Oh my good. I'm trying so hard not to bump the microphone. I bumped it slightly a few times. Hopefully it's not bothersome. Okay, there we go. Oh, that was really short, actually. There's a couple more of those later in the game that are much longer than that. Man, I want to look around. There's so many times where it's just like, oh, I want to look around and look at the scenery, and Nintendo's just like, no, frick you. Get the star and leave. Man, I thought you were about fun, Nintendo. I want to have fun looking around. Alright, and that is 12 power stars, so we got 9 this episode. Pretty nice progress, Galaxy complete. High score, blah blah blah, we didn't get a whole lot of those. New Galaxy, oh wow, already. That's so many. Alright, well, thank you for watching this episode of Super Mario Galaxy. This was only episode 2. We're only just getting started. We have 1/10. Yeah, 1/10 of all the stars. So, I don't know. We might get this series done in 20 or less episodes. That'd be a good amount. If we're getting 1/10 in 2 episodes. I anticipate later galaxies will, of course, take a bit longer. So that's why I'm saying 20. Mario's tired of listening to me. He's sick of my nonsense. Anyways, I will see you all for episode 3, where we continue exploring the galaxies in the fountain area. See you then.